You'll see the Australian national men's and women's sevens rugby teams training here at Victoria Barracks in Sydney, the birthplace of the Australian Army as we know it today. We'll explore things like leadership development. What do we expect our players to be able to deliver as leaders on the field, and also for us as professional soldiers as well?
We've had an iconic history with many of our rugby players serving, so that can be really aspirational, inspirational for our athletes, and likewise for people in the Army to be paired and see players training here actually have a connection is something that the forces overseas can actually engage with here in Australia and overseas as well. So it's a match that makes at every level a whole lot of sense.
On the spring tour, what's a pass mark for the Wallabies?
Oh, I mean, they are determined to go there and win all three games. So, I mean, that's the start point, that's the pass mark from where they are, from their perspective. That's the expectation that certainly Michael's setting for them, and there's no reason why they can't do that. They would be very confident that that they can come home with three wins. No one's suggesting that we're happy with the lack of wins. We also play the All Blacks more than any other country in the world, so we have that pass mark, and that's the benchmark that we set for ourselves. We played Ireland earlier on in the year. They're second in the world, beat them in the first test, arguably should have won that series, gave ourselves enough opportunities. So I think as we move into the UK tour, it's a slightly different style of rugby, different emphasis, and I think the preparation the All Blacks will have given us is the best platform we could have going into that spring tour.